Blackpool, a town of dreams and a town of nightmares. It's as sweet and warm as candy floss, and yet as bitter as the malt vinegar on your chips. It's a town of flashing lights and a place of darkness. A place where people fall in love along the promenade, and yet it's a town with the highest divorce rate in England. A town geared towards our most basic and hedonistic impulses. And it's a town with the highest rate of alcohol-related deaths in the United Kingdom. It was once the jewel of the north. Now, an empty shell, rotting under the watchful eye of the angry Irish Sea, whose roaring black waves batter against the sea wall. To some, it's a magical place, full of happy childhood memories, donkey rides along the beach, saucy postcards and illuminations. To others, it's a place to run from. It's a town of memories. A town of melancholia. It's a place where working people will come for wild weekends, their brains fried and warped by cheap beer and kiss-me-quick hats. The Benny Hill theme tune playing in constant loop around their heads. On a lonely stretch of promenade stands the world's largest mirror ball, a solemn monument to the dance hall tradition. Long gone are the wartime glory years where Blackpool was the playground of George Formby and Frank Randall. With the right kind of eyes, you can still see the ghosts of the better days, visions of Vera Lynn and prosperity.
Oh.
proud and pertinent. It's reduced now out of season to a ghost town, a place for the people with no place to go. A treasured spectacle for the lovers of theme parks, now abandoned. Is the reason for this bleakness cheap holidays abroad or funding cuts? Wherever the finger is pointed, one thing is for certain. The quirky, fun-loving town we grew up in is something very different today.